How to mix the right watercolour paint colour. In this video, I'm going to show you how to mix the right watercolour paint colours that will be needed as a foundation wash on this lovely bee eater bird. And first of all, I'm going to go for some phthalo blue. So I'll just bring that into shot for you. That's this one here. Now don't do this over the top of your painting, okay? Because if you do, you know what's going to happen? You're going to drop water all over your painting. I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes, you know that. Alright, so some phthalo blue. I need to water this down. Because that's a lovely blue, isn't it, phthalo blue? But you see it's not a bright blue on the picture, is it? Not as in really bright. So if I get some scrap testing paper, you're looking at something like that, maybe a little bit more. Water it down. There we go, that's a better look. So very watered phthalo blue. That's one colour mixed already. Then we've got to think about the green for the head, haven't we? Now that's quite a bright green. Now as per usual, when I do a painting, I do plenty of testing first of all, as you can see here, okay? Test those colours out. Match the colours on your test paper, scrap watercolour paper as you can see, to your reference photograph and just match it up and see if it's the same kind of colour. Now if you're like me, you've got your reference photograph on a tablet or an iPad, at least then the colours should be about right. And really zoom into that reference photograph. And I mean zoom in like this. And you can see the colours within each individual pixel. We've got those bright yellows, well more like a bright lime green, isn't it? Within some of these areas here. When you really look at these little squares, these little pixels. You know, but when you look around, you can see you've got some browns in there. You've got some kind of rich reddish colours within the top of the head as well. I know. But when you go down to the blue, yeah, I mean, this is really blue down here. So that could be the phthalo blue, something like that, maybe. The only way you're going to do this is by testing it out and finding out yourself, you know. So the green in question I'm going to go for is probably this one here. So lemon yellow and phthalo blue. So move that around. Let's put it off that painting now, shall we? So we'll go for the lemon yellow. I've got a little bit left in my half pan here, as you can see. Now, I did spray down these half pans probably about 10 minutes ago before starting this painting. And I do that just to ensure that it softens them down a little bit first. So lemon yellow, and just a tiny amount, that's probably too much, of phthalo blue. Well, I don't know, that might be all right. Let's make some more up anyway, I'm going to do some more. But that's the kind of colour we're looking for.
So what I do, I get some scrap watercolour paper. Try the ideas I've got out on some scrap watercolour paper first, just on one side of that little sheet of paper. Then I'll match that up to my reference photograph on my tablet. But when you look at something, let's say for example the top of the head here. Let's get one of my tools here. I'm going to drag some colour off. Get ready for this. I know I've ruined the photograph, but never mind, eh? Never mind. I'm sure Mandy West, who took this photograph, won't mind too much at the moment. When you zoom into these colours, I know, look at that. You've got a variety of different sorts of browny green colours, haven't you? This one's got more red in it as well. But these are the colours from this part of the head, from the kind of forehead here. But again, when you really zoom in, you can see a variety of colours kind of try and match up to. But it's going to give you some ideas of sort of colours that you find within the reference photograph.
We'll go for some lemon yellow. A bit more water in there. I'll make sure that all of these are to a water consistency, okay? Very watery. So lemon yellow, phthalo blue, and a little bit of burnt sienna, I think, with this one. So it's going to be a warmer colour. Sort of a warm green, really, we're looking for. Lemon yellow, limon. So lemon yellow, phthalo blue, and a little bit of burnt sienna, I think, with this one. A little bit more. Burnt sienna. And you see how that one changes as well. And you can see this colour is more evident towards the top of the head, isn't it? A little bit more. And again, if you're not sure, test these out some scraps of watercolour paper as well. And see how it goes. Probably a little bit more phthalo blue. Trying to get it more on the kind of deep green side. Something like that, really. It's not far off. So again, I'm going to get a quick test. Give a quick go on there, let's see what that's like. Yeah, that's not too bad. More like a deep green. What we can do is add a little bit more of the burnt sienna just in one corner to begin with and see how it goes. It's going to flood into that anyway. See, everything's on an angle here. Not too bad. So just trying to get that colour just right. Oh yeah, that's it. Just trying to get that colour just right is what I'm trying to say, okay? Right, so we'll stick with that for now. So that's another colour.
You can see with the blues, it's not a bright blue, is it, for that tail at all? This is a really good way, as you can see, by picking out them pixels within one area and dragging them out. So if you've got an arty program on your computer that you can do this with, go ahead. If you haven't got one, there's free online arty programs as well as ones you can download. So have a look around on the old internet and see what you can find. But you look through here, you've got some lovely different shades of blue, which then turn a little bit green, don't they? So these are, again, colours I need to try and work out and try and mix. Probably looking more towards phthalo blue, indigo, maybe a little bit of a dark or like a lamp black added to it, just to dullen it down a bit. Or maybe a little bit of brown, like burnt umber. I don't know yet until I start playing with the colours.
And then we're looking for this colour here, which is phthalo blue and burnt sienna. So it's quite a dark, kind of rich colour, isn't it? So phthalo blue. You probably don't need too much of this at the moment. And burnt sienna. Look at that. What a lovely colour that is. Maybe a little bit more burnt sienna. Keep washing your mixing brush out between colours though. So I don't want to be putting phthalo blue into my burnt sienna colour in there, do I? Not really. So when you do mix it within your mixing well, just remember to wash that brush out afterwards before you go to a different colour, okay? Well, even if we went back to that one, you're now putting that darker brown into the burnt sienna. So keep washing it. Okay, so far. Now let's go for mixture. Let's have a quick look at my mixers here. Let's go for Gambo Hue and Cadmium Orange, shall we? So again, a drop of water into your mixing palette. Gambo Hue. Now this is vital to get these colours right before you make a start. Because as I said, these are the foundation washes. These are the main structure, the main background for the feathers when we start adding those on later on. So you need to make sure these are about right in the colour-wise anyway. So Gambo Hue and Cadmium Orange. It's quite a lovely rich colour, that one. A little bit more water in there. And again, give it a test as well. So a lot of preparation work for this, actually, for this painting, because we have got a variety of colours within the main picture, haven't we? So you have to remember that when you're looking at the photo. So it's worth taking your time, getting the colours right, before you make a start adding those colours to the paper. And I'm going to go for one more. Just one more for now, okay? Cadmium Orange, Scarlet Lake and Burnt Sienna. Let's go for that one next. Again, to a watery consistency. Okay, it's quite a nice colour, actually, that one, isn't it? Oh. So we'll test that one out as well. Oh, it's a lovely colour, very rich.
Finally, I want to make up a mix of Indian Red and Raw Umber. This is a lovely soft brown. This is ideal for the back of the head and also under the wing. I don't really want to make this too creamy, not to begin with anyway, because that gives you room for manoeuvre as well. So once it's dried, it's going to dry a little bit lighter, which then means we can gradually get darker as we go through the painting process. But this is a lovely colour mix to work with as well. Now that we've mixed all these colours, I'll quickly show you how I use these to apply a foundation wash on this very colourful bird. So I make a start on the phthalo blue, and you can see because the paper's nice and wet, it blends really nicely. And then added to that, a little bit of lemon yellow and phthalo blue mix. Because I'm looking carefully at that reference photograph and working with these colours, I'm changing the colours all the time. I mean, this has got olive green in it, with a little bit of French ultramarine and lemon yellow. And adding that into that mix as well helps it kind of blend together. I'm using these colours to look at the overall shape, and this is just some foundation layers behind the scenes, before we even think about adding those details over the top. When we go to the neck area, Then we've got to think about brightness. Got to work with lemon yellows or yellow ochres. A little bit of red in there as well. Because I really want this to blend together, as you can see. And then we can drop in a lovely mixture of orange, which is basically cadmium orange and some other colours as well, but sienna, scarlet lake. So working with the brightness of the colours. Now, even though these colours are very kind of watery at this present time, I know they're going to dry that a little bit paler, which then gives me the opportunity then to sort of work over the top of that. So if I want to add another layer over the top, I can do without going too dark too quickly. Now, the wing is really bright as well. However, it's not a flat colour. So I'm thinking about using these colours in more of a three-dimensional way when I'm applying these to the paper. So I'm kind of varying the colour mixes, looking at the reference photograph again to see where it's brighter and where it's darker. I'd also think about adding the blue in there. And again, as I mentioned, this is all the background foundation washes, all ready and waiting for me to start to think about applying the details over the top. So this will give us some ideas on how I tend to look and mix in my colours before I make a start on that painting. For more on colours and mixing, head to the video to the top right. I'll see you there.